The year 2020 looks to be another exciting and very progressive year in our community.
The more we participate, the more we're going to get those the money returned back.
It's a safe community, absolutely, but we still have to be vigilant.
Hi, I'm Linda McHugh. As we welcome the beginning of a new decade, Mayor Mark Sokolich reflects on some of the highlights of 2019 and talks about what residents can look forward to in 2020.
As you all know, our new post office is scheduled to come online in late spring. It's going to be attached to the new parking facility, which we opened about 2 months ago. Once that post office opens, where the existing post office sits, that'll be converted to a new passive park for everybody to meet their friends, have a cup of coffee. Right down the block, our new theater, which we are really excited about, is scheduled to open in early fall. The construction will be complete in late spring. We'll then spend a few months getting it ready and just getting all the protocols and procedures down, and the grand openings will start in early to mid-fall. Soon Fort Lee's going to have film festivals, we're going to have showings, we're going to have guest speakers, and it's all a way of celebrating our history as the first Hollywood. In addition to the projects, the theater, and of course the post office, we also have a lot of other little projects and initiatives that are going on and will be completed in 2020. Our rec center down by the middle school is in the process of being completely refurbished. That should be done in another 30 to 60 days. One of the most important initiatives that 2020 we'll have is to make sure that we provide enough senior citizen housing for our seniors here in the borough of Fort Lee. We're in the planning stage, we're working with the housing authority, we're working with grant companies, we're working with the county of Bergen to make sure that funds are available so that we could build new senior citizen housing here in the borough of Fort Lee. And right now we're talking about constructing it right here in our municipal parking lot behind Borough Hall. In addition to that, that senior building will include a new senior citizen activity center. 2020 will also see a lot of the phrase Be Fort Lee. It's Fort Lee's new marketing and retail branding campaign. It's a way of bringing attention to the borough of Fort Lee and everything that we have here. And then of course 2020, we're hopeful we'll see the commencement of the final phase of redevelopment 5. The 4 acres that are closest to the George Washington Bridge are slated for more residential and also a hotel. There are many other initiatives that are going on. We'll continue to maintain and make sure that our emergency services have the absolute best services and resources available. And we'll also make sure that the health, quality, and safety of the residents of the borough of Fort Lee will continue in full swing. So Fort Lee 2020 looks to be a very exciting year. We're not sitting on our hands. We're going to continue to progress. And we're going to continue to make Fort Lee one of the best communities in the state of New Jersey. So have a happy, healthy, and prosperous 2020. And if you need me, call me.
Beginning in March, the U.S. Census Bureau will be inviting households throughout the country to take part in the 2020 census. The census is simply a headcount of every person living in the United States. But for municipalities, it's more than just that. The count helps determine how billions of dollars in federal funding are allocated to towns like Fort Lee for critical public services like schools, roads, and fire and emergency response services. This is why it's so important that each and every one of us take part in the census.
I want as much diversification as we could get involved in this because I really want to make sure we're counted, because I really think we were cheated last time.
Our district took a different shape. We lost the congressman from our district, and they put it someplace else.
At a recent meeting to start spreading the word about the upcoming census, Mayor Sokolich met with various community leaders to ask for their support to help get every person in the borough counted this year.
It's critical. Every head needs to be counted. In 2010, we had the census, and I don't think Fort Lee was counted properly. I think we lost a good 5,000 to 6,000 residents. And because of that, we lost grant monies, we lost funding, and we weren't counted the way we should have been counted. It's so critically important that every resident of the borough of Fort Lee participates in the 2020 census.
It's very important to us that we get this census correct this time. We need everybody to sign up.
Based on the statistics, I think we are supposed to get about $3,000 per person per year. So if one person doesn't participate throughout 10 years, we're gonna lose $30,000 that's supposed to come to Fort Lee.
If you don't participate, you're not only cheating yourself, but you're cheating the entire borough of Fort Lee, and that's not fair. We're going to make it as easy and as safe as possible. We're going to be rolling out programs, how to do videos, people available to train you if you don't know how to go online. Whatever you need will get done.
We're planning a census day for all ages on March 28th, where we will have people who can translate in Chinese, Japanese, and Korean. It'll also be presented in English, and we'll have laptops available for people to actually go online and sign up for the complete the census.
This is the first time you'll be able to complete the census online, by phone, or by mail. And it's important to know that by law, all census responses are completely confidential, and your personal information cannot be shared with anyone, including law enforcement agencies.
Today we talked about during the meeting, bring the senior citizen to the library and help them to complete the forms and things like that. So we are planning many different things. So let's see what happens. This 2020 is a little bit different, and you know, we need to get educated.
We are a very, very diverse community, and there's a lot of languages here in the borough of Fort Lee, and some folks don't speak English all that well. So it's important that we make sure we coordinate with all the agencies and all the local groups, from Korean to Russian, from Chinese to Italian, making sure everybody is counted. That's how important it is.
人口普查非常重要，每个人都要积极参与。这关系到镇里能有多少讲中文的公务人员，学校会不会发写有中文的信件让孩子们带回家。
Para participar en el censo de 2020 es muy importante que llenes el formulario. Toda la información es segura y privada.
모두가 참여해야지 우리들한테 들어오는 그 benefits를 다 받을 수 있기 때문에 꼭 참여 부탁드립니다.
Police have seen the number of car thefts in the borough increase over the past few years, but the reason may surprise you.
If everybody locks their cars and takes their fobs with them, virtually the car theft will stop.
According to USA Today, thieves stole more vehicles in 2017 than they had in any single year since 2009. And the biggest reason might have nothing to do with criminals being cunning. Deputy Chief Stephen Gallagher says the increase in car thefts is due to a combination of new technology and drivers being careless when leaving their vehicles.
When I first became a police officer in the 1990s, a car thief, in order to steal a car, would have to actually break the locks or break the window, go inside the car, and then they would have to break into the ignition to override it to start the vehicle. Now, car thieves don't break into cars anymore. They don't carry tools. Car thieves now just try the door handle to see if the car unlocks. If it unlocks, they get inside. They hit the start button, and if a car starts, they can drive it away. It's that simple. If the door handle doesn't open, they'll go to the next car.
Gallagher says some of the newer high-end vehicles also make it easy for thieves to know if you've left your car unlocked.
Mirrors are retracting when the car is parked and locked. So the car thieves can look at the car sometimes, and certain models, makes and models, they can tell if the fob is in it just by looking at the car. If the mirrors are not retracted, then they know the fob has been left inside. The people who are stealing the cars in Fort Lee aren't coming from Fort Lee. They're coming to Fort Lee. They're coming all over Bergen County and Union County and Morris County to steal their vehicles. Fort Lee is a safe town, but there's criminals everywhere. And like I said, we're one bridge away from the busiest city in America, possibly even the world. So yes, we're in that close contact, you know, that we have to be vigilant. A simple thing to do, lock your car door. Take your keys, take your fob with you, and lock your car door every time you leave it. Don't leave it running, don't leave the key in it. For the extra second or two, it's peace of mind. If you have anything of value, put it in the trunk, out of sight, out of mind. If they look in the car and it's empty, there's a less chance of somebody's gonna wanna break into it.
That wraps up our show. Happy New Year, and we'll see you again next month.